Hey, Heather. So great to see you. How are you?
Really good. Just getting settled into my new life. It's been both chaotic and amazing at the same time. And it's great to see you too, even if it's only over Zoom.
The number one thing I think of when I think about how great it is to be home and how amazing this transition has been is how thankful I am to have worked for Televerde while I was incarcerated. Something you chose to do as well, right? So a question that I had for you is, how valuable was it for you to have the opportunity to work for Televerde while incarcerated?
Having the opportunity to work for Televerde was everything. When I came to prison, I was starting a 7-year sentence, and all I saw in front of me was the future that I lost. I was losing my son during the most formative years of his life. Any plans that I had to continue my education came to a halt, and that was really something that was very important to me. And I knew that also with the pace of technology, I would get out of prison to face a world that had moved on in every direction without me. I didn't know how I would ever be able to one day find a meaningful work, a career, support my son and myself. And having Televerde really gave me my future back.
Yeah. Heather, everything you just said resonates deeply. It feels kind of like you're walking into the abyss with little hope that you can actually grow in a place like prison. The deck is stacked against you so much that when you come out, it's next to impossible for most people to find their footing. This explains the nation's 3-year recidivism rate of almost 70%. People get released from prison and they can't move forward. They're lacking a number of things like skills, education, support, and a path forward. And then adding insult to injury, the overwhelming majority of companies won't even consider someone with a criminal background for employment.
Exactly, Kristin. And that's what Televerde changed. So I came to prison without any sort of career. I was a low-wage, low-skilled worker, and I was able to leave prison in May of this year as a seasoned marketer. I have sought-after skills. I have a virtual Rolodex of professional contacts, and that's allowed me to be more competitive in the job market. I was also able to land a job immediately with a starting salary similar to that of a 4-year college graduate. So now, you know, just leaving prison in May, I'm able to support myself and my son. And this isn't the trend in the American prison system. You and I and all the other Televerde women are anomalies when it comes to that.
That's absolutely true. My career track was different from yours, which speaks to the many options we have when we come to work for Televerde. In my role as a customer success manager, I'm supporting some of the most recognizable brands in technology, using business language and working in technology platforms that over a decade ago were foreign to me. I was skilled and upskilled and set on a path for continuous learning throughout my tenure with Televerde while I was incarcerated.
It seems like Televerde gave you a lot of confidence, and that's something that it gave me as well. Did you feel confident in who you were professionally prior to Televerde in your incarceration, or is that something that it also had that same effect on you?
Yeah, that's a really good question. And I think those of us who end up incarcerated don't see some of the potential in themselves sometimes. And that was a big issue for me. So working for Televerde taught me so many things like confidence, communication, business acumen, and how to make the best decisions. And these are all really extremely valuable skills that I never thought I'd learn while I was incarcerated. Televerde has helped me to completely restart my life after a 10-year sentence. I've been out almost, I think we're well into the 430s by now, and this is the longest this is the longest that I've actually been in society since I was 16 years old. And furthermore, I'm officially off all community supervision starting January of 2021. So I came to prison broken and left whole, thanks to Televerde.
Yeah, Televerde really changed our lives for the better for both of us and a lot of the other women.
Absolutely.
So we both decided to take that opportunity to work for Televerde during our time incarcerated. And being a part of a program like that, as we know, many people have very strong opinions about. And so I'm curious, did you feel exploited at all by Televerde?
So this is an interesting question. Since I've been out of prison, I've seen a bunch of media headlines and social media comments suggesting that for-profit companies that use prison labor are exploiting us. I'll speak to my own experience. Working for Televerde is completely voluntary. It's something that I chose to do. It is the highest paid job in the prison, but the money wasn't actually what really mattered to me. Don't get me wrong, it was definitely a plus, and I always loved being able to send money home to support my family, in which that allowed me to reclaim some of that independence I lost coming to prison. But what I'd say was priceless was all that I learned. The technology applications, the business acumen, sales and marketing skills. Much like you mentioned earlier, Heather, you know, you came out a seasoned marketer. I came out very seasoned as well. So every day I came to the Televerde Engagement Center and I learned skills that I knew were changing my life.
And it's almost unheard of for a prison to have a program like this. It really is such a unique, life-changing experience. It's surreal to think about being able to have an opportunity like that in prison.
Yeah, yeah, completely. My journey with Televerde changed the trajectory I'm on today. That's 100% fact. They invested time in me, tons of time, tons and tons of hours, and just different people and knowledge and subject matter experts. And I was always more than just an inmate or someone performing tasks for Televerde. Our culture cares for people, and I don't think words can articulate the gratitude I have for Televerde. One of my favorite quotes ever was by my former CEO, Jim Hooker. I believe wholeheartedly he was one of the most smartest, forward-thinking, visionary individuals I've met. And the quote reads, "Discarding people for the rest of their lives based on a decision they made on the worst day of their life is such a waste of human potential," end quote.
I firmly believe that. And his quote is one of my favorites too. You and I both know women who have bought beautiful homes within the first year of the release, and they've been able to do this because of Televerde. The money that I saved while working for Televerde while incarcerated, it made the first days of my transition so much easier. I was able to get everything I needed to start my life again. And that is so important because you get nothing coming out of prison. As you know, it's just on you go to rebuild your life. So I was lucky enough to have family as a safety net, but many women don't have that when they come out. And being part of Televerde also gives us access to the Televerde Foundation, and that really further invests in our transition. So that has been so helpful to have the support programs, the mentoring, life skills training, how to manage a budget, just all the different strategies that help you cope with the emotional stress of reentry.
Yeah, totally, totally relatable and very, very true. Reentry is super overwhelming. And like you mentioned, you know, a lot of people coming out do not have family, and, you know, they didn't have or apply or maybe didn't have enough time to work for Televerde. So when they're released, you know, they're coming out with very minimal money trying to get their lives back on track. So you really have no idea until you experience it yourself. But having the Televerde team, which in many ways is like a family, made the reentry process far more easier. And that was because I knew that I wasn't alone.
I couldn't agree more. Televerde has made my reentry a million times easier. I often think about how amazing it is to have worked for Televerde while inside and how fortunate we are to have had the opportunity, because like you mentioned, a lot of women don't have that. And it makes me think about what my life would be like today without Televerde. How do you feel that your life would have been different if you hadn't taken this opportunity?
Gosh, Heather, that's a good question. I don't know really how to answer it because I'm not a fortune teller, but what I can say confidently is that I do not want the life I had prior to Televerde. Today, I feel like a new human. I feel fulfilled. I'm a productive member of society. And I really feel like some of us just need a little extra help, and that's what Televerde provided for me.
Definitely. Without Televerde, my transition would have been so much more of a challenge. I wouldn't have had the strong support system that I have. I wouldn't have acclimated as quickly without the amazing team of people. And that's really what I feel like. Like I have a whole team behind me supporting me and helping me just navigate everything that life's thrown at me since getting out of prison. And I don't think I would have been on the way to my goals as fast as I am. And I attribute a lot of that to my experience with Televerde and the foundation.
Yeah, same here, Heather.